His covenant. It did not land on the surface. So you got to train yourself to dig and find out what God is saying to you. Life lived in victory. Granted, it's what I'm all about. The reason I'm all about that is because that was God. I see life as something that must be conquered. And you can conquer it if you can discover the hints God put in His Word to show you how to be overcome. Let me this morning set you talk life. We are right where I said the road needs to grow. Life that you look at the 2020 vision. I want to talk about life.
All right.
So this morning I want to talk to you about sainthood.
Amen.
All right.
The making of a real saint.
All right.
If you have the Bible, turn with me to the book of Genesis, chapter 12. And you can hold it there, and then you can turn to Genesis, chapter 22. Let me just read a few verses. If you have a Bible where you're staying, the only reason I'm actually staying so the service didn't come back out of town, I had no standing. God told David, and I'm reading from another translation besides the King James, leave your country behind you and your own people and go to the land I will guide you to. If you do, I will cause you to become a father of many nations. I will bless you and make your name famous, and you will be a blessing to many others. I will bless those who bless you and curse those who curse you. And the entire world will be blessed because of you. Abram departed as the Lord had instructed him, and Lot went too. Abram was 75 years old at that time. He took his wife Sarah, his nephew Lot, and all of his wealth, the cattle, the slaves he had gotten in Haran, and he finally arrived in Canaan. Turn with the girl to the 22nd chapter of the same book. And this, let me read to you. Later on, God tested Abraham. Abraham, God called. Yes, Lord. Abraham replied, take with you your only son. Yes, Isaac, whom you love so much. And go to the land of Moriah and sacrifice him there on a burning offering upon one of the mountains which I will point out to you. The next morning, Abraham got up early, chopped wood for fire upon the altar, saddled his donkey, and took with him his son Isaac and two young men who was his servants, and started off to the place where God told him to go. On the third day of the journey, Abraham saw the place in the distance. Stay here with the donkeys, Abraham told the young men. And the lad and I will travel yonder and worship, and then come right back. Abraham placed the wood for the burnt offering upon Isaac's shoulders, while he himself carried the knife and the flint was striking the fire. So the two of them went on together. Father, Isaac asked, we have the wood and the flint to make the fire, but where is the lamb for the sacrifice? God was seated with my son, Abraham replied, and he went on. When they arrived at the place where God had told Abraham to go, he built an altar and placed the wood in order, ready for the fire, and then tied Isaac and laid him on the altar over the wood. Uh-huh. And Abraham took the knife and lifted it up to plunge it into his son to slay him. At that moment, the angel of God shouted at him from heaven, Abraham, Abraham! Uh-huh. Yes, Lord, he answered. Lay down the knife. Don't hurt the lad in any way. Uh-huh. The angel said, well, I know that God is first in your life. You have not withheld even your beloved son from me. And Abraham noticed the ram caught in the thorn of the breast. So he took the ram and sacrificed it instead of his son as a burnt offering on the altar. Abraham named the place Jehovah Provides, and it is still called by that name to this day. The word of the Lord is blessed.
Years of being told by God to offer up
the son as a sacrifice that promised him and went 25 years to wait for. Yes, years of many challenges in life before he could be called the father of the faithful. Look at him, if you will, my friend, my careful study. Called by God to the Ur of the Chaldees at the age of 75. Five promises made to him. One being, I will make you a great nation, meaning that I will give you a son. 11 years passed, he's 86 now, and no son in sight. In chapter 7:15, you can see Abraham's pain. He and his wife got so frustrated with this promise that they cooked up something that she said, take my hand, Hagar, and have a son through her. And Ishmael came into being. It was not until 125 years later, his wife being 90, that the promise was fulfilled. The promised son, Isaac, was born. Read the story between the lines. 25 years of waiting, 25 years of praying and hoping, 25 years of trying, 25 years of month after month being disappointed, 25 years of trying to keep your head up, 25 years of a broken heart, but still worshiping God.
My mind.
Saint making is a process. Many people, my friend, if they was waiting this long, would have shoved God to the side, quit church and said, there's no use. Now add to that, that's not enough experience for Abraham. Add to that, just a few years later, God says to Abraham, offer up Isaac, that promised son that I gave you. Isaac, who you waited 25 years for. Isaac, that you love. Isaac, who is the love of your life. Offer him as a sacrifice to me on Mount Moriah. This had to be a heartbreaking thought to Abraham. I can hear him saying, not my son God, not Isaac, who I waited 25 years for, not he who gave me new life, not Isaac. You all know the story that I just read. The next morning, Abraham got up early, chopped the wood, saddled the donkey, and took with him Isaac and his. They saw the mountain. He and his son Isaac climbed the mountain with the wood on Isaac's shoulders. He carried the knife himself in the thick foot of fire. He prepared the offer, put his son on it, lifted up the knife to slay his son, his promised son of 25 years. At the last moment, the angel of the Lord shouted to him, Abraham, Abraham! Lay down the knife, don't hurt the Lord. There's a ring in the thicket. Offer him. For now I know I'm first in your life.
Now I know.
Let me back up. Because I saw more than just reading that text. This was not an easy thing for Abraham. Obeying God.
My.
It's a struggle.
Yeah.
This was a heartbreaking experience. Can you imagine those 3 days of traveling to Mount Moriah? many tears did Abraham shed? I see the picture. This man didn't sleep at night. Each night he was twisted and turned with the thought, I'm going to lose my son. His appetite was going to go down. Very little conversation was going on among him and his boy. The closer he got to Mount Moriah, the harder his heart pounded. How many times he must have stumbled when he tried to climb that mountain. I believe that if I could be between the lines, he stopped more than once just to get himself together. Saying to daddy, this is a heartbreaking day. We have done this many a time in the course I've been with you every time you made a sacrifice. I see the Lord, I see the fire. I see you got the man, but where is the sacrifice? How can you tell your boy that I'm getting ready to slay you? Are you feeling me? Saint making is a process. A process of many difficult experiences. My friend, twisted and turns. Not every day in saint making life is living a life of peaches and cream. Many dark, uncertain days. Standing at times, wondering which way to go. Being knocked down more than once. True, my friend, I'm saying it again. Saint making is difficult. Real saints.
Real saints.
On the road sometimes. Real saints also tell you real sainthood guarantees victory.
Yeah.
Real saints tell you, I've been out here a long time. I want to tell you, my friend, that you're a winner and not a loser. Real saints tell you, I've been through a lot of difficult situations. But when it's all over, you can shout the victory. Real faith. I'm telling you, my friend, I don't care how long you're there, this too is your path. Real faith. I'm telling you that God's tomorrow always will be better than today. Look at Abraham with me just one more time, please. 25 years waiting, hoping, praying. But the promise took those many years to be fulfilled. The promised son did come. Long time, many years, but it did come. When he thought he was going to lose all, God stepped in and blessed him with his son. Real saints can tell you God always has a way.
My.
You got to have your own personal testimony. Nobody.
nobody but God did this.
Many of us are saying, if now was a hand.